back. In this video, we talk about the 6 basic fragrances that I think can make a complete wardrobe for any man. Okay, confession. I would venture to say that as fragrance reviewers, we get asked one basic question more often than not. What do I need? I just want the basic stuff. So I'm going to use what I call a Jeff rule. One of my closest friends' name is Jeff. He loves fragrances, but look, talking about notes and all this other kind of stuff is pointless to most people. They don't care. Does it smell good? Do I need it? Am I going to get compliments? Does it work? Is it good value? Okay, give me 3 of them. That's what this is. One qualifier. When I say any guy, any man, I'm thinking you're going to be in your mid to late 20s and above. If you're younger than, if you're 20, you're 25 on down, I got a different list for you. It's going to be a little bit more cost competitive and different scents. So let's get into it. First off, you need a signature scent. You need something that's going to be able to be worn all year round. And that fragrance is going to be Bleu de Chanel Eau de Parfum. The quintessential cologne-like fragrance according to the fragrance community. But look, you just want stuff that works, and this works. It works in the office. It works in the casual environment. It works in special occasions. It works in formal situations. Beautiful fragrance, classy, sophisticated, cool, subtle, get it. To the spring, man, I love this stuff. Terry Mugler, Mugler Cologne. Straight out of the shower, douse yourself in this because it comes in a splash. Put on your jeans, your Henley, your chukka boots, go outside in that crisp spring air and have a great day. No, it's not a performance beast, but who cares? The juice is lovely. And a lot of people compare this to Creed Original Vetiver and Neroli Portofino for the scent profile. I get that also, but it's a fraction of the cost. Check this juice out. Into the summer, we get the master, Tom Ford, Grey Vetiver Eau de Parfum. The Marlboro Man steps off the billboard. This is by far the one fragrance I recommend to most of my friends who do not wear fragrance. Why? It's quintessential masculinity. It could easily be your signature fragrance, and oftentimes it is. But I saved it for the summer because it performs exceptionally well on my skin in the summertime. It's a beautiful, beautiful fragrance and a massive compliment getter. I'll be doing a re-review on every one of these fragrances, on most of these fragrances coming up. When we get into the fall, we get our Terre de Hermes Eau de Parfum. We get that juicy, dirty orange with that vetiver. Ooh, the leaves are turning. It's getting a little cool outside. It's football season, and this fragrance feels like all of that. And it's classy, and it's cool. And it's laid back, and it's memorable. Love this juice. Love it. Love it, love it. Gosh, every time I wear it, I can think about a time I got a compliment or a good thing that happened. Matter of fact, I get compliments for all these. That's what makes them so good. Then we get into the winter time, and I wear something that I've been rocking since day one it came out. I don't like the bottle, but it's Spice Balm. Pink Pepper Cinnamon Leather. I love this stuff because in the wintertime, you need something that's going to cut through that cold air and all those layers of clothes you're wearing. It's going to lean gourmandish and it's going to leave an impression. Spice Balm leaves an impression. There are some people who don't dig it as much because of the pepper, or it's maybe a little bit more aggressive. People compare it to Bulgari Men in Black. I like it for those reasons, and it lasts forever on me. Then we get to our special occasion fragrance. Another one by the master, Tom Ford. Tom Ford Noir Extreme. Man, amber goodness. Every time I wear this fragrance, I can just feel it wafting through the room. And I just look to see people's expressions, if they're within my projection range. Every time I wear it, compliments. If it's that special occasion, a special situation, it works. And that's the beautiful thing about each one of these fragrances on the list. They just work. Now, Mugler Cologne aside, they all perform exceptionally well. So they're going to work all day long on your skin. You're going to get good performance, you know, not beast mode. You're going to get good projection and good sillage. So there you go. Your 6 basic fragrances that I think any guy could use. Do me a favor. What would you recommend if you could only pick 6? Remember, 27 or above, try to keep it non-niche, and make a unique fragrance choice. It's not as easy as it may seem, but I'd like to see what you would recommend because, hey, not everyone wants to have a closet or wardrobe or several coolers full of fragrance. Sometimes you just need a few to get the job done. Hopefully that helped. Until next time, talk at you later.